This After Effects tutorial is going to show you how to animate a shape along a custom path or any object and how to auto-orient. So let's start with a new composition. We're going to go ahead and set it to 4 seconds. Okay. All right, so I'm going to say File, Import. We're going to bring in a file called Arrow. Open, we're choosing Merge Layers Footage. This brings the Arrow Illustrator document into my program. I'm going to drag it into the composition. So now I have an arrow that I can use. I'm going to right click or control click on the arrow, and we're going to go to Create Shape from Vector Layer. So this creates a shape, right, with points. It's now vector. All right, so what we're going to do is move our arrow over to the side. We're going to make sure that we've clicked off of our layers, and we're going to create a path now. You create a path, a vector path with the pin tool. So your pin tool is going to remember your last settings. You can see fill and stroke here. A trick to get no fill is to click the fill, the blue words, and you have your option for none or solid fill. Yours might default to a solid fill. In that case, when you start drawing and when you're trying to make a path, you're going to see that it fills itself with a solid. That is not going to be useful. So if that happens to you, instead of clicking the color and looking around for your none button or no fill, you're going to click the word fill and be able to select none right from there. All right, so that's how you would make a path. I'm going to go ahead, select my path layer and click delete on my keyboard so that I can make a looping path. Again, no layer selected. I come to my composition here. I click, hold, and drag. That allows me to create a curved shape, loop. I'm going to do it again. Looping, and one more click off of my page. All right, so I now have a path. This is the next really important part. You're going to expand the arrow, expand the contents, expand the shape, expand the path, come to where you see the path where it has the stopwatch. Make sure that's selected. You can say Edit Copy or Command C. Now you're going to come to your arrow outline layer and you're going to say Edit Paste. Nope, not yet. You're going to select that layer and open Position. You're pasting your path into the position as keyframes. So you're going to click P on your keyboard, select Position. Now you can say Edit Paste. And you can see that those keyframes went into my position. Now, important to note, wherever your cursor is on the timeline is where those are going to paste. So if I want that to start at this one, then I would paste it here and it starts there. So wherever my cursor is where it's going to paste. Okay, so I'm pasting. I can turn off the path that had the blue outline. And now when I click the spacebar to see how my arrow goes, you see it moving around. All right, so that's great. I really don't need that path anymore, but I'm going to keep it so that we can see what it's doing. So in this case, I'm going to click it again. You can see the arrow is staying in the same position, pointing to the right. If I want it to look like it's actually following the path, what I'm going to do is switch back to my select arrow. I'm going to click my vector arrow here. I'm going to right click on it, so control click, and come into Transform Auto Orient. That will give me a pop-up window, and I'm going to say Orient Along Path. Okay, you can see it slightly rotated my arrow at this point. And this time, if I click spacebar, you can see my arrow actually stays pointed, right? The direction that it's moving on the path. Wonderful. So another trick you can do to adjust speed is in your position, you can select a keyframe and pull it out. So this is making the entire animation move slower. Right? Another thing I can do is adjust just the speed of some movement in the animation. So it's sped up just around that middle curve, and that's by dragging the keyframes in the position. All right, so I hope this quick tutorial helps you add objects around custom paths in Adobe After Effects. Good luck!